It's Saturday, August the 11th, and it's Arlington Million Day. For the first time since April 28th, out here for live racing. Oh, but don't you worry. I've had over 500 bets this summer, so I'm not deprived. Let's see how the big day turned out. I think it's going to be a good one.
Is asked to run, gallop home now, and win the war by a length. Coming on is Hanalei Moon, the Mark Cassie pair. 1-2 and super striking. It's win the war in front, and going on to score as expected. Win the war takes the Duchess, a length and a quarter.
Learned something new today. Here at Gulfstream, I wanted to play Canterbury Downs in Minnesota, and it wasn't a surprise that they couldn't take my live bet because it wasn't being simulcast. But when I told the girl, that's okay, I'll bet it on Express Bet, I went back to my seat, went to bet it, I got an error message. The message said, if you're going to use our Wi-Fi here at Gulfstream, you can only bet races that we're simulcasting. What? Oh, no problem for this guy. Turn the Wi-Fi off, bet the races, and collected.
For the stretch on the outside is Dan Plata. Inside is Note Escura. Nothing separates these two. Nose to nose, but now outside Dan Plata's got a half in front. Dan Plata by three parts of a length. Note Escura trying to come back on the inside. These two talented horses battle. And in the end, it's Dan Plata who surges to the championship in the MTA Sales Graduate Futurity.
Out of almost in Tanger Rose comes now, and in Tanger Rose on a mission to go up and take over down the outside, running on fairly well Sociologist, but it's in Tanger Rose in front, and in Tanger Rose puts a space on them now, and down the outside Sociologist finishing really well in Tanger Rose by about a length and a half down to the wire, and the favorite is safely home in Tanger Rose second.
They turn for home. Our Limo Joe cruises to the eighth pole with a four-length lead, isolated on the outside, then Johnny U, followed by Estricator. They're coming to the 16th pole, and Our Limo Joe, Jose Ferrer was on a Cadillac today. Our Limo Joe cruises home to win by 3.5. Isolated a solid second. Estricator. They're at the top of the stretch. Mame is now coming after the heavy favorite, Alter Rhythm. Alter Rhythm, a two-length lead. Mame moves right into second. They're followed by Music Maker in third. They're coming to the 16th pole, and it's Alter Rhythm with a 2.5-length lead. Mame, a good effort, but she can't catch Alter Rhythm. Alter Rhythm scores by two. Mame was second.
The catch remains the trailer. The half mile in 47.59 seconds, under a quarter to go. Three quarters in 113.06. It's Chaz the Man. Diamond Maze now looms as Prue capitulates. Golden Gift is charging. Now angles out. Dancing Rock. And on the outside is Spanish Justice, who's staying on. They're deep in the final furlong. Diamond Maze led from Golden Gift, Spanish Justice, and here's All Call right over the top for Jose Valdivia Jr. All Call won by a length and a half.
Mr. Jägermeister still held together confidently here, and Mr. Jägermeister now starts to quicken the tempo, and he puts away Cinco Star and Moonlight Joey and Tuco Bayer, left in the wake of a keen turn of speed, and Mr. Jägermeister showing that class without being asked. He's opening up here in the Derby. Cinco Star all out, Moonlight Joey trying to close the gap, so is Tuco Bay, top of the stretch in the Minnesota Derby, and look at Mr. Jägermeister go. He's off by five. Mr. Jägermeister says it's happy hour in Shakopee, and the drinks are on me. He is cruising down the Canterbury stretch. This is an impressive performance. Mr. Jägermeister emphatically to win the Minnesota Derby.
approaching the quarter pole. Liz's Cable Girl sailing along, has a three-length lead. The whip is out on All Flatter, drifting out while chasing. And Agora will add a little suspense as to who finishes second. But this is a one-horse race. Liz's Cable Girl in a class of her own here, opening up to lead by 10. Agora gets into second, and then it's All Flatter third. Just a stroll in the park for Liz's Cable Girl. Jose Ferrer just had to hold on, and they win it by 10 emphatic lengths.
Mason Dixon on the far side and then Sparky Ville. They are coming to the top of the lane now, and Instagram still the leader. Instagram goes on for home, leads at three parts of a length. Owning is in second. Synthesis down at the rail and Sparky Ville. They're at the top of the lane, and Instagram now's given his head and he's striding away very, very impressively. And look at this guy go. Instagram 9-10 lengths coming home to a scintillating performance in the best spell. Could not have been more impressive. Drayden Van Dyke just let him run along on his own.
Doville is being ridden to assert. Robert Bruce at 24-7 remains last. 3/4 and 1/12.96 seconds. They come to the quarter pole. It's Century Dream who's just the leader. Right there is Money Multiplier and Oscar Performance sweeps on the outside. Circus Couture up the rail. Toward the inside is Doville. Here's Aminar, who's striding on the outside and gearing up for a run. Robert Bruce at 24-7. It's Century Dream. Here comes Cacho and DA between horses. On the outside is Aminar. And here's Robert Bruce, who's charged up to the lead. It's Robert Bruce. Robert Bruce has won the match.